गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू आर ऑल सेफ एट होम। इन लास्ट क्लास वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट वेयर हाउसिंग। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज द 14th चैप्टर इन यूनिट 3, दैट इज ट्रांसपोर्टेशन। ओके, सो आई थिंक यू ऑल नो मेनी थिंग्स अबाउट ट्रांसपोर्टेशन इन योर प्रीवियस क्लास इट्सेल्फ, दैट इज types of transportation, city surface transportation, water transportation and air transportation. Transportation is a integral part of commerce. Okay, so it removes the hindrance of place. Okay, that is, it helps the people to get the goods at a correct time. Okay, so transportation helps many ways in commerce as well as in our day-to-day life. Okay, so transport facilitates the smooth carriage of goods from place of producer to the place of consumer. That is, here they said that not only the goods, the person also, that is smooth carriage of goods from the place of producer to the place of consumer. So the goods are transported from producer to the consumer. Okay, so this is the concept of transportation. Transportation also facilitates traveling of people from one place to another. So it helps the goods to move from one place to another place, not only the goods and also the human being. Okay, so the different types of transportations are surface transportations, water transportation and air transportation. Surface transportation, otherwise known as land transport. Okay, so before going to see about the types of transportations, let us know the meaning and definitions of transport. Okay, so goods have no use unless they are made available at a place where and when they are wanted. That is, it is the consumer get the goods whenever they want. Okay, so therefore transportation here helps the people to get the goods at correct time and at the correct places. So it means to carry man and material from one place of production to another, resulting in creation of place and time utilities. So it gives not only place utilities as well as time utilities by giving the product at a correct time. Okay, so according to K.K. Saxena, the transport system acts with reference to the area it serves in the same way as a candle does in a dark room. You know what a candle does in dark room? It gives a light. Okay, likewise here he comparing the transportations with a candle. Okay, the next one is about types of transport. Let us see one by one. The first one is surface transport. So transport of people and goods by land vehicles all comes under this land transport. So in land transport there are three types are the one is pack animal, another one is bullock cars, the next one is road transport. Okay, so first we see about transport, surface transport. So transport of people and goods by land vehicle is known as land transport. In that, the first category is pack animals, that is, so using animal we are transporting the goods from one place to another. In case of backward areas, hilly tracks, in all those regions they are using animals to carry the goods from one place to another place. So animals like horse, mule, donkey, camel, elephant, all are used in hilly regions or backward regions in order to carry the arid forest regions in order to carry the goods from one place to another. In deserts also we are using animals to carry the goods, that is to transport the goods. So animal transport has also played a significant role when there is no road and railway transport. So when there is no road and railway transport, we are using animal as to transport the goods from one place to animal, that is called here pack animals. The next one is about bullock carts. Okay, so bullock carts, so it helps the rural road transport in India, that is bullock cart helps the rural people to carry the goods from one place to another. Not only the goods as well as the passenger. It carries the passenger from one place to another. It carries the produce of sale to the market and the consumer goods to the villages. So it gives it also helps the producer as well as the consumer to get the goods at a correct price. The next one is about pathway transport. So pathway transport is the oldest form of transport found in hilly areas. So forest areas as well as in remote places. Here it is used by human being for transport. Then road transport. The most important transport is road transport. Okay. Nowadays we are getting many things in local, that is in our domestic places through way of road transport. So it is suitable for short and medium distances. It provides a basic infrastructure for bringing the majority of people who are living in far off villages into the mainstream of the nation, like by connecting them to different places. So it offers number of advantages such as flexibility, reliability, speed, door to door services. All those things are the advantages of road transport. So the efficiency of road transport, it increases the efficiency of the other modes of transports also, because by using the road transport, the lorries, buses, as well as sometimes road transport is used for to transport the goods to railway stations. Okay, so it is the most important transport in land transport. The next one is about motor lorries and buses. So the credit of the revolutioning the road transport and introducing the elements of speed and greater carrying capacity into the system goes to motor lorry and buses. So introduction of petrol engines and later diesel engines vehicle has been offering good competition to the railways. The next one is about tramways. So here some pictures are given about the pack animals as well as bullock carts, which is used in remote areas. Okay, so then we are going to see about the tramways. It made their appearance in the 19th century as the forms of transport suitable for big cities. Okay, so this is suitable only for big cities. Tramways are initially horse drawn, later it is steam powered, and now electrically it is operated. That is, initially it is drawn by a horse, they followed steam powered. As nowadays we are using electrically operated tramways. So it carrying the capacity is large, that is it carrying capacity is very large. It is able to cope up with the peak hour traffic in big cities. With the greater popularity of motor buses, tramways slowly decline. Then Madras city had tramways till 1933. So in Madras till 1933 they are using tramways by way of using the horse. The next one is about railway transport. The invention of steam engines by James Watt, you know already who invented the steam engine, by James Watt. So because of James Watt, the mode of transport all over the India, that is railway as a mode of transport, is the most organized transport undertaking all over the world. So railway are the cheapest as well as the quickest means of transport for carrying heavy goods as well as the passengers. So it renders many services to it requires huge capital for outlay. That is, we need huge capital to outlay the tracks, construction of bridges, purchase of locomotions, all those things. But it helps the people because the cost of railway is very cheap compared to other transport. So among the biggest public utilities of a country, railway is the most one. Rail transport is a means of transferring of passengers on as well as the goods on wheeled vehicles running on rail. Rail transport started to be important in the industrial realization. There are three types of tracks that are in operation. They are meter gauge, broad gauge and narrow gauge. Next we are going to see about the advantages of railway transport. So here tramways, example for tramways, already you know about railways, all those things are given as a image. Okay, next advantages of railway transport. So railways are suited for carrying the heavy as well as the bulky goods. It provides long distance travel as well as it is the cheapest means of transport. and it can provide better production and safety to the goods than other transport. Though initial investment is large in long run, the operating expenses will be very low in railways. That is, initially we need large investment in order to construct all the tracks, all those things, but the expenses, that is operating expenses, daily expenses needed to run the railways is very low compared to other transport. So it is a cheaper mode of transport. It requires less time than motor transport for carrying the goods for long distances. It has regular schedule of timing, that is in correct times the railways are run their railways. So it provides unaffected services whether rainy as well as shiny weather conditions it operates. So these are the advantages of railway transport. Next we are going to see about the disadvantages of railway transport. It is a inflexible one because as it operated to a particular track which cannot be deviated from the set routes, that is it follow the tracks only. Okay, we cannot change the routes. Railway rates are relatively higher than motor transport for transporting lightweight articles over short distance, but if we use it for short distance then it is higher charges is carried out than in rural areas. It cannot offer adequate traffic because of uneconomical operating cost. Then it requires heavy investment for installation of tracks. Railways are not fully utilized, and if wagons and coaches are to half empty to its capacity, heavy financial burden will be cast on the railways. So these are the disadvantages of the railway transport. Next, here it is given metro rail. Okay, it is in Chennai, you know very well. Then next one is about monorail. So these are the different types of railways nowadays. Recent trends in transport. So it is metro rail. Already I said it is metro rail. Metro rail is a mass rapid transport systems. That is, metro means MRTS. Mass metro rail is a mass rapid transport system. It is a convenience as well as a fast, efficient one, comfortable mode of urban transport. Rapid transit, also known as heavy rail, metro, subway, tube or underground, it is a type of high capacity public transport generally found in urban areas only. Okay, so not in rural areas. Then next we are going to see about monorail. It is like a train, but instead of having two sets of wheels that balances on a railway tracks, the monorail is balanced on top of one rail. Okay, so monorails are often used to transport people around large cities. Some monorails utilize magnets also. Okay, magnets to hover on their rails, reducing friction between the train and the rail. The first monorail was invented in 19th century itself. Then we are going to see about the bullet train. So bullet train is a high speed rail, is a type of rail transport. The first such system began operates in Japan in 1964 and was widely known as bullet train. High speed train normally operate on standard coach tracks of continuously welded rail. The next one is about pipeline transport. It is a mode of transportation of goods and goods or material through pipe. Liquid gases, nowadays we are getting gases, all those things comes under this pipeline transport only. So liquid and gases are transported in pipelines. Pipelines exist for the transport of crude and refined petroleum, fuel such as oil, natural gas, biofuel, etc. All are used through pipeline only. So this is about pipeline transport. Next we are going to see about conveyor transport. It is a broad category of transport mode that includes modes developed from the idea of conveyor belt. That is, if they are using the conveyor belt, example include conveyor belt, two or more pulleys with a continuous loop. Example are escalator, elevator, or comes under these categories. So nowadays we are using in Pothis also, they are using this conveyor transport to carry the passengers. Then next is some pictures of bullet rail and a pipeline transport. That is, they are transporting the gases, natural gases as well as petroleum, all those things transported through pipeline transport. Next, a picture of ropeway transport. So elevator, all those things comes under these categories. Escalator, elevator, then hyperloop. The another category is hyperloop. So these are the modern transport system used nowadays. Next we are going to see about water transport. Okay, so the word water implies the transport. Here water transport is boaters, yachts, all those things comes under these categories. So now we are going to see the meaning of water. Water is a free gift of nature. So human civilization, through gradual application of science and technology, that is in Asian periods, most of the transportations are carried out through water only, waterways only. Remarkable advances are taking place in water transport due to considerable improvement in the construction, design, motive power, speed and safety of ships, boats. Water transport is the process of moving people, goods, etc. by a barge, boat, ship or sailboat. Okay, sailboat can over a sea, ocean, lake, canal, river, etc. comes under this category. This category does not include articles on the transport of water for the purpose of consuming the water. Water transports are of two types. One is inland transport, inland waterways, and another one is ocean waterways. Okay, inland waterways includes a river that is carrying goods and goods, all those things through the river, canal, lake, all those things comes under these categories. So inland transport comprises rivers, canals and lakes. It is also known as internal water transport. Water, generally small boats and steams are operated on rivers to transport the people and goods. Where rivers are deep enough, large ships can also play on them. So canals are man-made waterways constructed for the twin purpose of navigation as well as for irrigations. The advantages of inland transport, that is water transport, here it is considered as the cheapest mode of transport. It carries goods smoothly. It is the most suitable for heavy loads. There is lesser pollution in water transport. Initial investment on river services as well as expenditure on their maintenance is much lesser compared to the road and railway transport. That is, initial investment is less compared to other transport. Then disadvantages, it is the slowest means of transport. Flood costs during rainy season, lack of flow of water during summer season affect the playboats and streams. Sometimes rivers also change their way. It leads to stoppage and uncertainty in usage of this means of transport. Then we are going to see about the ocean transport. It is playing a significant role in the development of economic, social and cultural relation among the countries of the world. So international trade owes its growth to ocean transport. It enjoys a pride of a place in aiding international trade. Cheapness is its great virtue. Next, the types of ocean transport is coastal shipping and overseas shipping. Okay, the coastal shipping constitutes an important means of transport in all the countries having a long coastal line. It is the cheapest means of transport for the movement of bulky cargoes like coal, iron ore, etc. to domestic ports of the country. Usually coastal shipping trade of a country is reserved for national shipping. In India, coastal shipping trade is now exclusively reserved for Indian ships. Then overseas shipping, it is a means the passenger and goods have to cross the ocean. Example, India export goods to America. Then ocean going ships may also be divided into two, namely liners and tramps. Okay, there are two types of liners. One is passenger liners and a cargo liners. Trams are essentially cargo vessels. Then we are going to see about the air transport. So it is the fastest as well as the costliest mode of transport. Okay, so the ticket for the airways is very high. So it is a costliest mode of transport as well as the fastest one. Commercial air transport is now one of the prominent modes of overseas transport. So in order to export or import any goods, we are using airways for costly goods. Okay, so the modern air transport has its growth with the invention of aeroplane by Wright brothers. Okay, so air transport is of a form of travels in vehicles such as helicopter, hot air balloons, plimps, gliders, hang gliding, parachute, aeroplanes, so then jets or comes under this category. Then domestic and international flights. Here there are two types, one is domestic and international flights. Air travel can be grouped into two general classification. One is domestic and another one is international. Flights from one point to another within the same countries are called as domestic flights. Flights from a point of one country to a point of different country are known as international flights. Travelers can use domestic or international flights in either private or public travel. Then advantages of air transport, it provides regular, convenient and efficient as well as quick service. Then we can transport perishable goods like fruits, vegetables, eggs, meats quickly to other countries. It does not require huge investment for construction and maintenance of track like railways. They provide comfortable services with this for passenger as well as to the goods. It can be used to move goods to areas which are inaccessible to other means of transport. It is a very much helpful for flood or landslide or war rises to the occasion to save the human lift from danger, human life from danger. Then next one is about disadvantages of air transport. So next we are going to see about the disadvantages of air transport. So the followings are the disadvantages of air transports. It is very costly mode of transport. The first one is, it is a very costly modes of air transport. Aircraft are not quite suitable for carrying heavy loads, weights, etc. It is not dependable because of unfavorable weather. Then the construction and maintenance of aerodromes involves a huge capital expenditure. So these are the some disadvantages of air transport. Services of transport to business, how it is useful to business to increase the efficiency of the production. It stimulates wants by increasing quantity as well as variety of consumer goods. It develops and expands the market. It helps in price stability. It aids to economic growth. It helps in specialization. It encourages innovations in producer. So these are the services of transport to business. Next we are going to see about document used in transport. So the followings are the document used in transport. They are way bill, okay, railway receipt, bill of lading, air consignment note. All those things are needed in order to transport goods from one place to another. Then next we are going to see about common carrier. Is a person who is engaged in the business for carrying goods for hire indiscriminately for all persons. So there are organization transporting goods on designated routes according to a fixed regular schedule offering transport goods for hire or hire. Then railways and sea transport do not come under these categories. For example, city buses are a common carrier. Under common law rules, common carrier is generally liable for all the losses which may occur to property. Okay, the technology advancement will make the transportation highly sophisticated with greatest speed in future. So transport play a prominent role in the economic development of a country by helping the people as well as the producer, that is the commerce, business community and a public in an enormous way. So today we see about the transport, that is land transport, air transport as well as water transport. So students study well in order to score more marks in your public. So not only that, November 2nd, your October monthly test started. It will be starting. So you must study the lessons in order to score more marks in your October monthly test. The portion for your October monthly test is 4th lesson, 5th lesson and 6th lesson. That is 4th, 5th and 6th. So these are the chapter you have to learn in order to score marks in your October monthly tests. Study the short answer as well as very short answer and long answer and exercise in 4th lesson, 5th lesson and 6th lesson, as well as submit your note at correct times in order to score the assignment marks. So study well, students. Thank you.